This is the Ecobee app for the Ecobee Smart Camera. If you only have had thermostats or light, you might not have noticed this up here. This is something that will get added to the app once you add the camera. We're going to come back and talk about this a little later because I want to come down and actually show you the camera itself before we talk about that option up there. So here you can see we have our camera. It shows 8 minutes ago it detected something, as well as a snapshot of what it detected. It does have a tap for live view, and this is also how we get into the camera itself. This is the current live view. From here, we have the ability to make this larger simply by selecting the square in the right-hand corner. Notice if I don't toggle it by moving my phone, it will automatically snap back. So we're gonna quickly do this. Nope, now that we have access to the pan tilt options, our record, our voice, and a quick snapshot, as well as the ability to play a siren and toggle audio. If I either move my phone or tap this to come back to our original view that we had, we now see those same options as buttons underneath. So here we have our volume button. We have a snapshot. Doing this will take a picture, notice, saved to my history. So that's just an image of what was happening. I can tap once to talk and you'll see it's green. So audio is now going through the camera itself and turn that off. Here we have our record. Record will show you exactly what's happening in the live view. If you happen to come into your motion event while it's being recorded, you will also see this listed so that you can choose to stop your motion event right from viewing, or you can let it go and it will record its 2 minutes. I'm going to stop that right now. We have our pan tilt options, and notice that we still have a timer going there, so it's going to take a little bit before that turns off. We have our pan tilt. Now, this is a single point of focus camera. However, it does use some digital wizardry to actually move the lens around a little bit. So notice it doesn't look like a regular pan tilt camera, and that's because it's not. It's digitally moving and stitching things together to give you the illusion that it's actually moving around. If we tap the center button, that will actually snap it back to its center point. If I wanted to, I can say this right here is what I want to be my center point, and I can press and hold that center button and it will lock that in as the center point for the camera. Notice right here we have an X that will close our pan tilt options, but we also have our minus and plus sign. What these will do is allow you to digitally zoom in using the camera. And here I'm just gonna bring that in as far as it's gonna let me do. And this is my one gripe with the camera, is that it's kind of slow in its actual zooming in and out. You can see, you can get realistically very close to things. So that's our maximum. If we wanted to, we can press and hold and that will slowly pan back, or we can hit our center button there, which will force the focal point to go back to its original point. Now notice, it is not jumping back to its start point. It is slowly pulling back. And that's one of the things I really wish they did a little better, because that's all being done digitally and not via optical. It takes so long to do because there's a lot of wizardry that's happening underneath the hood. Now, that also means if I pinch to zoom, you'll notice that it kind of slowly goes in. It doesn't actively go whoop and zoom right in. You did see that I can also move the camera by moving my finger on the image as well. So this is nice that it's here, but not one of the main reasons I would get this camera. Selecting the X will close you out of the pan tilt. Here we have, tap that. Do you want to play the siren? Yes, you're going to play the siren. And I stopped the siren. Unbelievably, that was so loud that I actually heard it in my studio. It is underneath me. You'll notice that most of the options do take a little bit of time to go from, hey, this action has happened on the camera, to reporting back to the application itself. Right down here, this is our last bit. This is our view history. And this is going to show you all the things that have been captured by the camera. Notice here we have our manual recording. We have the snapshots, that's that image I took. And then here we have person detected down in the basement where I was testing originally. But notice something, the maximum clip size is 2 minutes. So that's something I'm iffy about, because you do need to pay for cloud services for the use of storing offsite. There is no local storage with the Ecobee camera. If I wanted to either view one of these, I simply tap on it. We have our skip back, play pause, skip forward, large screen view. We can delete or download this clip right there. If we wanted to delete multiple items, we simply select the pencil icon right there. I can do a select all, or I can pick what I want to delete. And then down here at the bottom, I select delete and delete, and those will be gone from the web history. And that's everything that we can do camera control wise for the Ecobee Smart Camera. However, if we come up here to the upper right-hand corner, here we have our sprocket icon. This is going to bring us into the camera settings. So here we have camera on off. So this is almost like setting that privacy mode. I do wish that they would have had this on the front where I could get to it faster, but in future updates for firmware, that could be an option. Next, we have our detection settings. Selecting detection settings, this will let us pick what we want to see. So right now you'll notice I have motion detection turned off. I don't care about motion detection. I want person detection. Tell me when a person is seen and then start recording. We have additional settings right here. So activity zone, if I select this, it's going to give me this grayed out grid. That means right now that everything is acting as a detection zone. If I select my pencil icon here, I get these along the corners and I can actually manipulate this to some extent of an area that I'd like to have monitored. I'm going to reset that because I like having everything as an active detection zone. I like that it's there, but I wish it was a little easier to use when selecting a detection zone. Here we have motion sensitivity. This has low, medium, and high. So how sensitive are the triggers for this camera? Sadly, there is no in between. Like, I can't slide this and go in between. It's either low, medium, or high. That's it. That's all you get. Coming back down here, we have smart focus. Smart focus will automatically pan and zoom the camera when it detects something. So in the case of a person, it will attempt to follow that person. But remember, this is digital only, so you are going to get some weird looking angles, as well as it's focusing on the person itself, not necessarily panning up to their face. So that is something that I wish they would do better, especially if I have person detection selected, but it's a good option to have if you want to use it. As you can see, it does do a very large, wide shot, so I don't necessarily need it to zoom in on something, but when I had it in the basement, smaller focal area, and I liked having it able to focus in on somebody. And that was all of our detection settings. Coming down, we have audio. We have microphone on and off, and then speaker volume. Notice that this is only on medium right now. It does allow you to jump it up a little bit better than the motion sensitivity. Now we have window mode. Will allow you to have the IR lights turn off because it knows that you're pointing it through a window. I like that it's there. I wish they called it something different. Here we have our device settings. Right there we have camera mode, which is currently on security. We can set it as a baby monitor. And then we have our device name, which we can change. Next, you have your Wi-Fi networks. Selecting that will allow you to change your Wi-Fi network if you needed to. Here we have support, if you needed to contact their customer support. And about, that's gonna give you information about firmware, serial numbers, lots of sensitive information. We're gonna stay out of there. And then Alex A integration, because just like any other Ecobee product, they exclusively operate with Alex A. So if you wanted to get the camera and forego an Echo device, you could, because you would have the ability to use those commands through this particular camera. Coming back to our front page, I wanted to touch on, once you get the camera, you will have the ability to arm away, arm stay, or disarm as a quick toggle. You don't get this when you have thermostat or a light. One other thing, we're gonna come down here. If we select autopilot, this will allow Ecobee to use your smartphone to determine if you're around or not and create automations based on that. Next, we have activity. This is going to be the feed of things that have happened. Notice I turn the siren on and off, camera, still frame, so it takes both. Over here, we have motion. This has been motion that we've detected around your house because you can set up a complete security system using all of these Ecobee products. So here we have kitchen sensor detected, upstairs sensor detected. So that's a light switch, that's a thermostat. This is a very interesting feature that you get with Ecobee that you don't get with a lot of other cameras because you already have a lot of the product built in. Here we have vacation mode. So I can set a vacation mode which will turn things on and off. You'll notice right now it's mostly for my thermostats, not necessary for the camera. And then discovery, well, this is gonna show you, hey, there's some extra things that you can do, try it now, blah, blah, blah. And then last thing that we're gonna talk about right here is the security options. Now, video clip, view activity, smoke alarm enabled, these are all things that you need to pay for. So if I select this, it's gonna bring me to the subscription page, and then you're gonna see for $10 a month, you have access to all of these features. You can compare plans. So that's the $10 for active, $90 a year if you pay ahead of time. That's for the complete. Or you have the standard, which is just self-monitoring, real-time alerts, video storage, etc. I recommend this one, $5 a month. It's not that bad. However, the active monitoring one, I don't see a need for unless you want to have a professional service monitoring you. And again, this is the shortcoming I feel for the Ecobee camera here, is that it requires that subscription. And I prefer things that don't have it. I want local storage. It is an interesting setup building it into my Ecobee family of products already, but you could see these extra options down here weren't necessarily as needed for the camera as they were for some of these other things. But that has been a complete look at the Ecobee Smart Camera, as well as some of the other functionality of the Ecobee app.